All right, here I am in Chiclayo. Spent the night here at the hotel, which may have been the nicest hotel in Chiclayo, but at $50 was like, hey, not bad, but I think it's the only hotel ever here and south of the border that offers breakfast at 6 a.m. already, and the breakfast buffet is actually quite impressive, if you can see that. So here I am, a little after 6, having breakfast. Hopefully getting an early start. So just yesterday was kind of an interesting ride. It started, first couple hours were all kind of in the rain, on and off, mostly on, through, southern Ecuador. Man, it was still kind of nice. You know, it kind of had that rainforest feel to it, very lush green. Lots of dogs on the side of the road, and that they weren't malnourished, which is interesting. They were actually good-looking dogs, but they didn't have collars. So there must have been like, I don't know, 100, 200 of them over the last 2 days. So just a huge amount of dogs, and they were just kind of laying on the road, on the side of the road. I don't know if people feed them or where they, you know, where they eat, how they eat. Like, they weren't malnourished. Sorry, I'm having a hard time with that word this morning. But anyway, it was, so then at the border crossing, and kind of as you got towards the border, the landscape really changed and it turned into more arid environment. Still a little bit hilly, but no mountains anymore, and certainly no, you know, no dense forest. And then got to the border, and border crossing took a little longer than I had thought based on the reports, but, you know, everything went fine. There were just a few other people there in line, and, you know, some other guys on bikes came up and started talking. So anyway, I made it to Chiclayo, which was kind of my minimum goal. I was hoping to make it to you, so I wouldn't have such a monster ride again today. But I have like 800 kilometers today, so we'll see how that goes. I think it'll be fairly easy. And then my goal today is the Airbnb in Peru. So northern Peru is kind of underwhelming. It was landscape-wise, it was still really arid. It was really trashy again. I mean, there was just garbage everywhere, it's kind of too bad. Some of it, I think, there was a lot of wind. So it was, you know, it was this arid, deserty almost environment, flat, mostly flat, some dunes even, a lot of wind, and then just like all these towns and areas, almost everything was just covered in trash. And I think the wind probably causes some of that, get blown around, but some of it is just, you know, I think it's just poverty, and people, you know, really don't have garbage service, or that's pretty low on their priority list. So it's a little too bad. Ecuador certainly was much cleaner than some of these recent countries. It kind of reminded me back going to like Guatemala, and Guatemala was probably the worst. Southern Mexico, a little bit like that. So we'll see what it looks like today as we get to Lima. But ride other than that was uneventful. I was having a glitch with the bike where it wasn't switching between ride modes. It wasn't a big deal. But it was switching, but you had to like come to a complete stop. So last night I kind of rinsed off the bike. It's had a lot of mud on it from that mud ride in Colombia. And that seemed to have fixed it. So I was able to switch between ride modes again. Again, not a big deal, but happy that's working. And then got dirty again yesterday. So I'll hopefully give it a good wash when I get to Lima. Met some nice people on the road. One couple from Lima that was visiting Ecuador and Colombia. They passed the border ahead of me and ended up getting stuck last night. The gal kept texting me. She gave me a sticker she wanted me to post in Ushuaia. I'm like, sure. So then they stopped and invited me for some refreshments along the way, but I don't know, my Verizon wasn't switching over, so I didn't get the message until later. And then the time I got to the hotel, I texted them, and then they were like, oh yeah, we had a flat or whatever, and we didn't get as far as we wanted, so we'll see, maybe I'll see them in the morning.